Start with the great name of Allah, who is the most Rahman and Rahim. Honorable teacher, Assalamu alaikum. Here I am Annie from B8 class. Today the topic of mine is research method in education. First of all, I would like to introduce here that what does mean by research. So I can say here then that a systematic way of discovering new knowledge is known as research. Basically, another word we can say that research is an ongoing systematic process that is based on variable evidence that leads to generalization about problem and the development of theories. After that, I would like to explain here that what does mean by characteristics of research. So the first point is here that keeping this in mind that research is any field. What does mean by research is basically, so I can say here that research is any field of inquiry is undertaking to provide information that support the decision making in its respective areas. I want to summarize here that there's some desirable characteristics of the research. So here the research should be systematic. The first one, quality or characteristic of the research, is research should be systematic. In this I want to explain here that research should be systematic. Why? Because if a researcher want to do a perfect research design or process, then it will have to evaluate or obtain the necessary information from the market in a systematic manner. Also, I can say here that it takes various steps to do a perfect or systematic research process, and all these steps of procedure are undertaking or interlinking to each other. The second one characteristic of the research is research should be empirical. So in this I want to explain that this means that any conclusion drawn is totally based upon ethical or hard evidence, gathered information collected from observation and real life experiences. The third one characteristics of the research is research should be logical. This is one of the most important characteristics of the research. The research is based on logical reasoning. Why? Because it involves both inductive and as well as deductive method. Without manipulating ideas logically, the scientific researchers can't make much progress in any investigation. That's why research should be logical. The third one characteristics of the research is research should be reductive. So in this I want to explain that this means that the finding of one research should be made available to other researchers to prevent them from repeating the same research. The last one characteristic of the research is research should be replicable. This is also a most important characteristic of a research. In this assert that there should be a scope to confirm the finding of previous research in a new environment and different setting with a new group of subjects or at a different point in time. So this is all about the research and in characteristics of research in education. That's the end of my presentation. Thanks for your concentration.